It's great to be coming with you today. I hope you're having a very happy Friday today. This is Raymond Mayfield. Now, it's really good to be back with you, all my friends and family. I appreciate you listening to me, and I haven't recorded live in a while, and so this is going to be the first time in a while, and it's just really good to be back with you. I want to call your attention to a scripture in Jeremiah 33 and verse 3. It says, "To call upon me, and I will answer you, and show you great and mighty things that I know not of." I want to talk to you about the power of prayer today. That prayer that word that Jeremiah gave in Jeremiah 30 and 3, he admonishes us to just call upon him. And he also tells us that he would answer us. And it also tells us that he would show us great and mighty things that we know not of. There's so much power in prayer. When you get in the presence of God and you begin to talk to God with all of your heart and you lay out your heart before him, he hears every cry that you hear. And the closer you get to God and the closer communion, the more things he will reveal and show to you in your life that you need. And we sure need to do that, because Jeremiah was written in a time of Babylonian captivity, and it seemed like it was a very difficult time for Jeremiah, because the people had gone into captivity because of sin and because of rebellion, and they turned and rejected God, and in turn God rejected them and sent them into 483 years of captivity. And that lasted for a very long time, and the last 7 years is going to be completed in the Great Tribulation period. But during that time, God did admonish him, and he said, "To call upon me, and I will answer thee." Even though they were in captivity, God still promises them that they will hear and answer prayer. And we, as individuals, it doesn't make any difference where you've been or what you've done. God will forgive you of anything you have ever done. But you've got to repent of your sins and call upon him with all of your heart. You got to lay down on your face before God. You got to get serious about what you're doing. If you will do that, God will answer you in great ways. You know, the reason we don't have a lot of things in our life, because we don't pray the prayers right, and we don't do the things right. And Jesus said in one place, the reason we don't have our prayers answered is because we asked amiss, to heap it up on our own lust. So when we pray, we need to consider others in our prayer. We need to focus on praying for other people. And when we start our prayer meeting, we should always start it out with praise and thank God for what he's already done and what he's already answered. He's answered so many prayers for me in my life, I can't begin to tell you how many times God has answered my prayers. Now, there are some times that I've prayed prayers that have not been answered, and sometimes we don't always understand why God don't answer that prayer. But friend, it's not up to us to try to understand about what God's motives and desires are. We just need to align ourselves with the presence of God and get in the throne room of God and seek him with all of our heart. And not only that, but listen to what he says to, but read his word to understand what God is saying to us. In Matthew 7 and 7, it says, "Seek and you shall find, and knock and it shall be opened unto you." That's something. If we ask and seek, it'll be open to us. And so we need to apply ourselves to pray. There's great power in prayer. And I want to tell you today, you know what? Fasting along with prayer is a very good thing to do too, because it really gets God's attention that we sacrifice ourselves that we might be in the presence of God. And I'll tell you what, it's just wonderful to know how good God is to it and what he will do for us in our life. If we'll just open up our heart and call upon him, he will show us those great and mighty things that we know not of. You know, it's been a few weeks since I've been able to be on the videos, and I broke my ankle, and it's been broken on both sides. And this is the first video I've recorded since I broke my ankle back 6 weeks ago, but I'm able to walk now on a walker, and I'm able to put weight on my foot, which is a good thing. And so I'm walking from one end of the house to the other, and I want to thank you for all that have prayed for me, and I thank you for prayers. Never forget the fact that God will answer every prayer that you pray and everything that you say. Be serious about God. Search your heart and your life to be sure everything is all right between you and God. You know, if you're not saved today, this is a great time to get saved because we're living in the last days. Jesus is coming soon, and I want to admonish you with all my heart to seek the Lord while He can be found. Call up on Him while He is near, because this is the time we're living in the day of grace, and we don't have much time. So I thank you for listening to this broadcast today, and the power of prayer is the most powerful thing in the world. And may God bless you today, and may you have a wonderful day.